Hello, this is Greg from SharePoint Maven, and today I would like to show you a little trick on how you can use your personal OneDrive to organize links and bookmarks. Let me explain to you what I'm talking about. Sometimes you need to organize links, maybe save some bookmarks to important documents. They could be links to some website or some other content that you have. And sometimes you just want to organize it all in one place. Now, when we have a SharePoint site, it could be a landing page or department site. There are a variety of ways for you to organize links. For example, I have my internet landing page over here. This is the communication site. And there are a few ways to organize links. There is a quick links web part over here, which allows me to create links. There is also a hero web part, which allows me to have the links and images and links kind of behind them, a little bit more visual. And of course, we can have links in the navigation menu. However, these links, they are typically visible and accessible by everyone, right? Obviously, if it's a team or a number of employees who are accessing the site, they will see all these links. All right. Now, that's not what I want. I want to organize my own personal links that nobody should really see or utilize. Well, for that purpose, we can utilize our OneDrive. Let me explain to you how that works. So you just navigate to your OneDrive account, to your OneDrive location. And this is this happens to be my OneDrive. Obviously, it's tied to my user ID. This is personal to me, private to me, meaning nobody has access to this unless I decide to share that content with the other users. And of course, I do have a number of documents, files and folders and documents that I organize in my OneDrive. However, we can also organize links. Let me show you how that works. So you can create a folder called links or whatever you want to call it, or bookmarks, all right, doesn't really matter. Here we go. Here's the folder. And normally you would be uploading documents in here, but in addition to documents, you can also create links. And this could be links to anything. They could be links to documents. They could be links to some websites. They could be, links to any content. As long as there is a URL to point to, you can link it. So I'm going to create a link, and it does give me, it suggests a number of files that apparently I recently worked on. And over here in this little field, I can enter the URL for the web page or a file that I want to point to. For example, here is, let's cover a few scenarios. I have this important document over here. I want to save a link to this. All right, so I'll just right click, copy link, generate a URL. Here we go. And now I can go ahead and paste this URL over here. And I can, of course, rename it if I want. I can leave it alone. All right, and hit create. And look at this. Here is a link. Here is a link. You have this nice icon showing that it's a link, not an office file, not a document. And when you click this link, all right, the name, it does open up whatever you link to, in this case, this particular document. All right. Here's another idea for you. Let's say you want to store a link to a website. Let's just say here is the URL I want to bookmark. This happens to be my blog. So I'm going to copy the URL. I'm going to again hit new link, and I'm going to paste the URL. It generates a kind of the name automatically here, but of course I can change the title if I want to. Hit create, and look at this again. It created a link, and pretty much if I click on it, it does open up another tab and essentially opens up that website that I just bookmarked. And look at this, right? I mean, essentially the links are stored in a folder in this case. Of course, they are private just because they are private, just because they're in my OneDrive. And pretty much you can use this functionality to organize your bookmarks. And I also want to mention this, the functionality I just showed you, I showed it to you in the context of OneDrive, but same exact functionality exists in SharePoint as well. So in a regular document library, you can do the same thing and create links. Very, very powerful, because sometimes you might have a library of documents, and then maybe you also want to point to an external source, right, from within the same library, maybe within the same folder, and you can pretty much create a link from your SharePoint document library as well. All right. Hopefully you learned something new today. I personally like this cool trick, and again, hope to see you as always on my YouTube channel or my blog, sharepointmaven.com. Thank you very much. Have a great rest of the day. Goodbye.